Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Predicting the Future. Today, we want to talk about a statistical method for testing effectiveness of vaccines. And that special method we want to talk about is about quadratic forms. So suppose there's a couple of companies made different vaccines, and we want to test whether they have the same effectiveness of protecting our body, or they are different. Suppose we have a sample size of A times B. The first row, X11 to X1B, is a sample of the experiment from company 1. The second row is a sample, is experiment result from company 2, and so on. So before we talk about the quadratic form methods, we want to first define what is a quadratic form. A quadratic form is basically a polynomial of degree of all its terms with 2 degrees, and if the coefficients are real numbers, we call them real quadratic forms. So these 2 examples here are quadratic forms. And before we talk about the method, we first need to talk about a theorem. This is the quadratic form theorem we're going to use for testing the effectiveness. Suppose we can write the quadratic form in terms of equation Q equals Q1 plus Q2 to plus Qk, where those Q terms are quadratic forms coming from NID normal random variables. And further, we assume that the terms Q divided by its variance, Q1 divided by its variance, and Qk minus 1 divided by its variance, are all have a chi-square distribution with different degrees of freedoms, respectively R1 to Rk minus 1. And the last quadratic term, Qk, is greater than or equal to 0. Then the theorem tells us that Q1, Q2 to Qk are independent. And how and because of the independence, we can further conclude that Qk divided by the sum of Qk divided by the variance has a chi-square of chi-square distribution with Rk degree of freedom, where Rk equals to R degree of freedom, which is the degree of freedom from Q minus other terms' degree of freedoms, minus Q1's degree of freedom, minus Q2's degree of freedom, until the last one, minus Rk minus 1 degree of freedom, which is a pretty beautiful theorem. So as long as we know the samples we got are all from a normal distribution RID normal distribution, and each of the terms are quadratic forms, and we know most of the quadratic forms they are quite chi-square and degree of freedom, then we can find out we can conclude that they are all independent, including the last unknown quadratic form QK. So let's see how do we construct a method of testing the effectiveness of vaccines. First, we define a couple of symbols. We define the x bar dot dot, which is the whole sample mean. And we define x I dot bar as the sample mean of the ith row, and define x bar ij as the sample mean of the jth column. And so if you look at now we look at this, the quadratic sums. So we construct the quadratic form of the sample. It comes from the sample variance. We sum over xij minus x bar dot dot square over all the ij terms. So this term we can rewrite it into, so we the internal xij minus x bar bar x dot dot bar, we write as we add a minus term and plus at the same term, we minus x bar I dot plus xi dot x bar I dot. We separate them into different terms, and we can write it into q equals q1 plus q2, where all the intermediate terms that we expanded from here are all zero. So the q term is xi is the sum xij minus x bar dot dot square. Q1 term is the sample minus the sum over the sample minus the row mean square. And Q2 is the sum of the sample mean, or the row sample mean minus the total sample mean. So now we write into into a quadratic equation. Let's see if we can find something from here. Because Q is actually AB minus 1 times sample mean, and by the one of the theorem, student theorem, we know that Q minus Q divided by the variance is actually chi square of AB minus 1 degree of freedom. And because xij are independent, so Q1 divided by the variance is the sum of a number of independent chi square b minus 1 degree of freedom random variables. Therefore, the Q1 divided by the variance is actually a chi square distribution of a times bracket b minus 1 degree of freedom. And by the quadratic form we just saw, we can conclude that Q2 is also a chi-square distribution with AB minus 1 minus A times square, A times bracket B minus 1 degree of freedom, which is A minus 1 degree of freedom. Now, let's rewrite this Q in a different way. Now we are subtracting X dot J bar instead of xi dot bar. We are subtracting that one and plus that one again. Same thing, all the intermediate terms are gone, it's all zero. And that is, we conclude that Q is actually, we can write it as a Q3 plus Q4, where we define Q3 as the sum of the sample xij minus the column mean. Column sample mean, and Q4 is the column sample mean minus is the sum of the column sample mean minus the total sample mean squared. And we conclude that Q3 divided by sigma squared is actually chi square b times bracket a minus 1 degree of freedom, and Q4 divided by sigma squared is chi square b minus 1 degree of freedom. There's something very interesting. If you look at both these two conclusions we have here, let's go look at the previous one. Q1 divided by the sigma squared has a chi square distribution of a times bracket b minus 1 degree of freedom. So it's actually chi square a b minus a degree of freedom. If you look at the Q1 term, the Q1 term is the sample minus the row sample mean. We don't know the real mean of each row samples, so we're replacing that with the sample means. So basically, we are losing. If we know the real mean of each row random row, the row in the mean of each rows, then this is actually a chi-square distribution of A times B. Because we don't know each row's mean, we are replacing A number of means, we are actually losing a degree of freedom. That's why it becomes AB minus A. And same for Q2, because we don't know the real total mean, we're replacing the total mean with a sample mean, which is X bar dot dot. We are losing 1 degree of freedom. Instead of having chi-square of A degree of freedom, we are actually having chi-square of A minus 1 degree of freedom. And same for there, we are losing the chi-square, some degree of chi-square distribution, because we are estimating the unknown, those unknown means. Every estimation, every replacement of the means, we lose 1 degree of freedom. Now let's look at this in another way. So this time we are subtracting and plus the x bar i dot term and x bar dot j term in the same time, and by simplifying that, we can conclude that can be written as q2 plus q4 plus q5. Q2 and q4 is the one we just saw. Q5 is a new term here. All the intermediate terms are gone, so those xi dot bar minus x dot dot bar times the new term, it's gone. It is easily can be verified, so you just have to write down the equations, expand it, manipulate a little bit, you can find out those intermediates and third terms as actually just gone to zero. And from the previous two equations, we know that Q2 and Q4 are both chi-square distributions with A minus 1 and B minus 1 degree of freedom. And by the quadratic form theorem, we know that Q5 divided by chi divided by sigma square is chi-square with A minus bracket A minus 1 times bracket B minus 1 degree of freedom. And that is coming from the total degree of freedom from Q, which is AB minus 1 minus the degree of freedom from Q2 minus degree of freedom from Q4. So which is good. So we the quadratic form tells us those complex random variables Q, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, and Q5. We know what their distribution are. Then we can try. So let's go back to the problem. We want to test how effective are those vaccines from different companies. And if they are all the same, then they basically means that they all come from the same distribution. Then we can construct the hypothesis testing for testing whether those samples we got from different companies having the same effectiveness. By doing that, our assumption is they all affect. They all have the same effectiveness. Then we can write down the ratio of any different, because the Q terms are all independent. The Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, they're all independent quadratic form. So we can use one of the terms, divide the other term, and that is basically the definition of F distribution. So now this is two examples. If we use Q2 and Q4, we divide both terms by its degree of freedom and divide these two terms. We got F distribution of A minus 1 and B minus 1 degree of freedom. Same thing if we use Q2 and Q5, we got F distribution of A minus 1, AB and B1 degree of freedom. And by using those statistics, F24 or F25 or even other terms, you can use FQ3 and Q4, you can use Q3 and Q5, and so on. You can use any of those statistics to do your hypothesis testing. By finding the value of the real F value, we know the P value of those statistics. And by checking the real p-value where it belongs to. If it's less than, if it's within our confidence interval, or let's say we want to be confident that this, our conclusion are 95% of confident that this our conclusion is correct, then if that p-value is within that confidence interval, then we can conclude they have the same effectiveness. If the p-value goes out of the confidence interval, then we can conclude that no, they are not the same effectiveness. So the same method can be applied to not only to testing different effectiveness of the vaccine from different companies, but also can be used for testing whether the vaccine is effective, whether they have real effect on people. So both, also the same method can be used not only for vaccine testing but also for many other applications, including testing effectiveness of different projects. So different projects from different teams, whether they have the same whether they produce the same amount of value and so on. So business owners, like management, can also use this method to manage teams more scientifically from data. And that's it. That's the topic I want to talk about today. I hope you like it. If you think this is useful and want to listen more, want to see more of those topics, please subscribe to my channel and like the video. Thank you.